I can talk a little bit about Andreas and Minna, who are the children, the you could say main protagonists in these books. They are growing up on this island without knowing their parents, and their caretaker is an old sailor, actually, who's brought into an existence as a caretaker at this island. And he's not the best of men. He's drinking a lot, and but he is very kind, maybe, to these two children and taking care of them. The more you read yourself into the book, you will discover that the death of the parents, or whatever happens to them, is intricately woven into the island's history in itself. There are many secrets to hide in this this island. And when Andreas, my main protagonist, who is telling the story, returns, he will discover layer by layer that the things he was told as a child is not true, all of them. So, but there's not one single secret to be resolved. There are many different things that are kept in the dark that he will finally more and more come to see. So it's you can say the entire book is a book about self-knowledge, trying to find out what happened to this island during the Second World War, during the occupation, is also one way for him to answer the question of who he is, and which I think is one of the topics of my novels in general, not only this book, but many books. The main character in the book is maybe the island, for many reasons, because it's a magical place. I grew up partly on an island like that, in the Oslo Fjord, the fjord just outside Oslo, the capital of Norway. And even if there was a lot of habitation around the island in itself was like a pure paradise. It was impossible to go, for example, by car on this island. You had to walk. In the middle of the island, there was this beautiful lake. And it's still considered to be a piece of nature. Plants and trees growing there are you cannot touch them or pick them. So it's a beautiful place. It's been gentrified now, but it's beautiful. And I think that growing up in this kind of place, where you have this beauty all around you, but you still know there's something hidden behind the beauty. And also as a child, I was always told that I could never step across certain lines, walk certain streets, take certain paths, because that would lead into the center of the island where this former Nazi collaborator, Jan-Heinz Kaufmann, as he's called in my book, lived or did not live or used to live, because nobody knew if he was alive or dead at that time. So I got, as a child, very early, this feeling of ambivalence, that something can be very mysterious and fascinating and beautiful, but still also hide something that is very evil and aggressive towards you.